Ten times a day. It's tension. The operative move is tension. Right, so. And we're both working, right? So he grabs. He doesn't want to try and lift his arm. I grab it, I'm cutting it down. So what he wants to do is he wants to drop his elbow towards his hip as he steps back. Right? That draws him down. Then, as I'm getting up, he's going to strike for my face, right? I need to walk, right? So I'm getting up actively, and I'm blocking, right? I want to be careful not to expose myself, right? And then in the same way that I use my feet when I am supine, right? In the same way that my feet are active when I'm supine. Okay. Let me do this one. My feet are active. active when I'm prone, right? People are doing this. What are you going to do without the lower half of your body, right? You need these legs, right? Then if his grip slips for any reason, I'm off. So you need your feet, right? Don't just walk them off. Notice when he does the ukemi, he's doing it properly. Good boy. He doesn't put his knee down. He can't put his knee down, right? So he's not going to like step back and put that knee down, right? He's going to go down the length of his leg in the same way that we go the length of our arm when we're doing my thing, okay? He goes the length of his leg. I want this in yoga. Then times have changed. Control of my body, right?
control.
Okay. Doesn't mean that I can't get up this way. Just a little more control. But trust me, if you will force your body to do this kind of role, it will teach you things about Aikido that nobody else can. Right? Because the kemi is the secret to our blending and supplements. Right? You will never have a more reliable partner than the mat. The mat's not going to jump out and hit you or do something unexpected. It's there. But it's hard. It is not going to forgive. So you need to figure out how to do it. So for this one, when it takes me down, right, I'm going to roll along the length of my body, and I'm going to take myself immediately as far away as I can. So I'm going to 180 degrees back. I'm looking for him, right? Then I'll post off of this hand. So it's opposite the slapping side, right? I roll, I slap, I shift, post off of this hand and this knee. People make the mistake of putting their foot over their leg. Now I just cut off my left leg, right? Post, kick through, stand. Okay. So, now, away, watching him. Post, post, kick through, keep going. Okay? Thank you. in time, bring them in front of you. Or ten shen, right? And then swing them in front of you. Right? So the first one is fairly simple. Yi. Take care, especially with somebody who's taller than you, right? This is not how I'm gonna throw it. Right? I have to own my hands. Then I'll raise, and when I feel the structure crumble, then I throw with my hips. Right? Tenkan, if I try to throw him here, he's behind me. I have to bring him back in front. I can bring him in front right here, or I can bring him all the way. And then tension, I step back, open up, and bring him in. Because of toy in me now. Hips and back this way. or I can attend con and bring him around, like this year. And I'm sorry, and one more thing. Who showed Kenny? Just my own personal take on this, but I know that, that some people learn to roll like this, to put their hands palm up and roll like this. I don't find that to be very satisfying. Because right, this, right, for him to hold his hand like this, as if he would do a roll on the back of his arm, right, this is a collapsing structure, right? It's just anatomically the way that works, okay? Right? But if he puts his palm out, right, now he's engaged his tricep, that is a strong structure, okay? So, try that, okay? Then, the mistake that people often make with the back rolls, rank beginners will do this, right? They go to do their back roll, and they put their arms out here, like this, okay? They're isolating your neck and your head, go up, okay? Right? Then next, you're a little bit more advanced, but you still don't have that idea of structure on the back roll, because you think front rolls.
Thank you.
very particular. Don't do it long. Slide back. He grabs. Right? Grab. And move your body forward. Use your hips to propel them forward. Slide back, step forward. That is the only other thing you're doing. Some of the things that we practice are to help us understand movement. Some of the things, some components of it are still really useful, okay? God wants to come and grab a much smaller person, right? And I start to come around and I'm trying to get around to grab her, and if she just steps back through me and strikes as hard as she can with her elbow, it's probably comes out here, right? And then I'm in a position where she can just push, right? And buy some time. Right? So, right? I start to grab and she slides away, right? I start to come around and she steps back through me and strikes with her elbow, right? Then she quickly moves to the other side and gets into the PTO position.
Okay?
Whichever one you do, this last one, right, or the other one, I'm now going to move in that. Okay. So I can step back through that 10 feet and move here. From here, don't reach like this. He's just going to smack him in the face, right? I want to slide to his elbow, right? So from his hand to his elbow, and then here. But don't stay here, right? I'm still sort of sitting in front. So from this position here, as I move to here, I'm going to move to here. Or slide and step forward. I get into this position and then around, right? People try to avoid this. Once I get into the United position, it's not really grabbing and pulling on the sleeve, right? From here, okay, I really, it's like this one is weighted and this one is here, right? Then I disappear and it's going to pull him with. So I'm not pulling on this. I'm just keeping it like this and I'm backing away.
Thank you.
going on here? Since they would say, I don't know, I was just a bystander. He started the whole thing. Tamura Sensei was telling the story, and they would go back after these things, and they would ask Sensei, because he was the one who was trying everything out on the streets, and they would say, well, what about this throw? What about that throw? And he'd say, I don't know, but we may not get rid of the worms. So, and yet, it's very difficult. So we get into this position here, okay? If I don't control him well, okay, and he squares up his body like this, this can be a problem. If I push him down too hard and I hook my arm here, this is a problem for me, right? Yidinage works like this, okay? I want his back to face my chest, right? And I want to control his elbow. If I don't control his elbow, then he squares up, right? So I need to control his elbow. The minute that I let go of his elbow, hey, what's he gonna do? He's gonna square up, right? So in order to really get this throw off well, I'm pushing, controlling through the elbow, and it just slides off, right? And you wanna be nice to your partner a little bit. But I need to be careful, right, that I maintain this kind of control the whole way. And then as it slides off, right, I'm really pushing my arm through. People hook, right? This is fine if I want to choke him out, right? But if I'm intending on throwing and I hook, it's actually going to leave him behind me. What I really want to do is I really want to roll and straighten my arm to throw him. So if he goes to do this, and I'm not giving Robert grief, but this is what happens, right? Okay? You will set somebody up for a takedown if you don't take this seriously, right? So what I have to do is I have to control him all the way through. I can't let him square up. Then I can do it. Okay? So be careful, but practice realism. Thank you. then I can easily disappear behind them, okay? So, right, I'm not going to leave the hand up, right? I've got to cut the hand down, and I'm not going to step from here, because they'll just shift and pivot, right? So, it's here. And this is in part why he slides away, it's because he knows if I'm smart, I'm going to be trying to economize, so he slides away from me, and I have to move quickly to catch up. I get it here, right? I want to drop, right? So, cut his hand down, right? And I move in, and I don't want to reach over his body, right? This is a problem. Instead, as I put this up here, I'm going to drop his weight, right? Just roll your arm back. And I want to dive my thumb as high inside of his collar as possible. Right? I'll break him down to this position. So, cut, move in, right? Over here, drop his shoulder, and slide your hand high inside his collar. Right? From here, you can go down nice and easy with the partner. Right? I basically want to have my knee in his back, or from standing, right, we're in this position here, move your foot out of the way, right, move your foot out of the way, twist your hips to throw. So, cut it down, slide in, drop your shoulder, slide your thumb high inside his collar, down to choke, or move that foot out of the way, twist your hips to throw, okay? Wait. Ladies, you may give me an eye. Thank you. say that we can't do a windpipe choke off of this, but your buddy's not going to be happy with you tomorrow, okay? So try to avoid doing this cut straight across the throat here. I'm grabbing high up in here, my hand just basically right, you know, right on the side of his throat, okay? And then when I pull, what I'm doing is there's his collar is cutting one side of his, he's cutting his left side carotid, and then my forearm is doing the right side carotid, okay? I'm not pushing across the windpipe. Try to be careful about that. Okay. So it's imperative that as he grabs, I use my body to force him forward, right? So he starts to grab, and I'm going to move him in front of me. Here and here. I want to see him in front. Thank you. Assume that you should just do like this one kind of opening, okay? He wants to get behind me, right? And if I let him get behind me, he's going to get behind me. So instead, I'm going to treat this as my own. So as he starts to come, right, I'm thinking of my attack. So the simple is how that heel goes. He grabs, and I move past him. Just drape, don't grab. You want to come to that position. Just drape your hand on his shoulder, turn your hips and step back, hang on, and then you can connect through the hip, right? And it comes to the right. Okay. He's going to try and latch on, right? But I can cut. So I don't have to wait. I don't have to leave it there for him. Or I can cut it. Try something a little more advanced. Then you actually grab it. Ukiyo-kishi. So I grab him around his body. I do my step 10 times. Bring him up on top. grab up on the back, grab on the waist. I bring him up and down. Softer.
gotta start from the back.
You gotta let it go when you see me.
Okay.
You only get one time.
Oh, okay.
This one, I'm not, right? I'm gonna grab on his arm. Or the one we just did it here. Right? Or me. Or son. Right? Or sweet. So any of these. Just looking to do openings, right? Tahiti, Shiko Sabati, Iri Sabati. Ukyo Sabati. Maki Sabati. Sumi. Okay.
Okey-dokey. If they can pull you over, right? So the point is that, you know, I'm trying to figure out what my grounding center is, right? So if I get into this position right here, what am I pinning? Well, I'm pinning his arm. Ooh, that's really dangerous. No, I have to be thinking about pinning him, right? Because if I'm in this posture here, it's not all that much for him to take my back or pull me over, right? I want a knee at least into his pelvis, right above his pelvis, between his pelvis and his lower rib. I want a knee right behind his elbow or right at his elbow. If I put it on his forearm, he'll release his elbow, right? Okay? I don't want to grab on the face. That actually is not so good. It's much better for me to just use the knife edge of my hand and push out through my center, right? That's much better. If I grab on, he actually understands that and push against it. But if I'm pushing out, it's actually harder for him to do that, okay? These are relatively simple things that I just don't want people to get that much. Two more minutes.
Thanks.
chill out. Nice chill out. All right, stretch your back. This is Kaisabaki practice. Right? This is knee bending and pushy practice. Right? And, you know, a Japanese bridge, this is called Hashimoto, because it means literally bridge movement. Looks like you're imitating a bridge. But not a Western bridge, a Japanese bridge. Right? Which means that your torso is upright and you're bending your knees. Right? Because if you want to do koshis, you can't do them with your foot. Okay? It's very nice to be back. You know, there are a few places, and only a few places, that I go every year. And I love it. It's like visiting family. For you, I get reunions. I love it. And this year's a big deal for me. This is 26 years I've been doing Aikido. Other arts before that, but I only. I made a decision a while ago that this is it. And, I may look at what Aikido perspective. I may look at what Aikido perspective on some other technique, jujitsu, judo, karate, kendo, whatever it is. But I only want to look at it from the Aikido perspective. I think that there's something really magical about this art. And we've all experienced it, as you're all sitting here with me. And you know, it's really interesting because at the outset, when you first see it, it's like, what the heck are they doing? How do they do that? You know, it is truly magical. Right? And then further on in your training, when you start to like sweat and creep and groan, and you get into the nuts and bolts of it, it's almost like you draw back the curtain on the Wizard of Oz, and you're like, oh, really? And you begin to wonder whether or not this is for you, okay? But then, if you really hunker down and look at the difference between Aikido and other martial arts, the perspective, the philosophy, right? I'm not talking about, oh, this martial art can beat that martial art, okay? It's a science and an art, okay? And even, you know, even our top instructors are still figuring it out. You lose that beginner's mind, well, then just pack it and go, okay? Once you accept that, and just accept that what you think you know, you don't really know, then I think it becomes magical. This is 20 years for my dojo, and you know, I remember when I came back from Japan, I was a fresh black belt, and I thought I was hot, you know what? Okay? And I got here, and I joined the United States Aikido Federation, and I was like, what the hell was I doing? I
chairman, and I can tell you that I have never been more satisfied in our federation and our federation's top instructors than nothing else in the world. We are, I think, truly fortunate in our federation. Very happy. Thanks.
Hey, how are your partners?
Good.